Good news and bad news on the second battery front. Mostly good news. It arrived. I put it on the bike. It seems to work. But they don't ship them fully charged. It's about 40% charged. And the package did not include the charger. So I have a battery with 40% power, but I can't recharge it. But I can't carry it for insurance. Turn around early because I don't want to take a chance of running out, especially on a hot day like today. But to count on a battery with only a 40% charge for even 10 miles, but we're going to do 28 and a half or so miles today, and there'll be some hills. 30 is usually about what I average, so difference should not be so much that I can't use this battery if I have to. A little bit cooler than it's been and it will be in the next few days, so I figured I would venture up into Fallbrook. Been maybe a month or so since I did this particular ride, so I guess it was next on the rotation. Ahem. that little bumpy mountain straight ahead, we will end up riding right past that. Friend once who lived in Atlanta and moved out west because he said Atlanta did not have enough sky. And I see what he means. Thank you. time to say goodbye to the bike lane. See, they are clearing all of this land. This used to be agriculture, and they are looking to put in a large housing development. So my hope is when that comes in, they will improve the road and add a bike lane. This is sort of a major corridor to get back and forth this way, so there is the biggest reason they really need to put in a bike lane, is there's a chance I'll get run over, but there's a much greater chance I'm going to witness a head-on collision by these cars swerving around me and the oncoming traffic. It's a good time of day to make this attempt. A lot of roads, you can be going against traffic, but since this connects up other roads, it's busy all the time. This is Sleeping Indian. This is where we're going to come out. But It's a lot of hill, even for the Kepler. And you can get up to it the other way easier.